that I've ever known. You give me purpose.
He does such a gorgeous job of adding compression to the vocal and then going back to the breathy sound seamlessly in every line.
Into your hands, it's myself to keep. I'll let you win with all that I can.
So here, where Justin was going more full voice, Jungkook's keeping it breathy, but adding it a cry from that breathy place. I've really never heard this done before.
Run, run, lost boy, they say to me. Feel like I'm walking my last steps.
And so I really love Justin's voice with the piano. It's so dialed back. There's so little instrumentation and it sounds so good. His vocal, I mean, would be beautiful just a cappella. Like, this is perfect vocal. His vocal is extremely breathy. Nothing in here is very connected. This is like a breathy chess voice. And I remember when I covered this song, it was like the breathiest I had ever sung. It was the first time I was really getting into that coordination. That's the great thing about doing covers like this, is that you'll get into coordinations in your voice that you wouldn't have otherwise thought of going. And I absolutely love the production choices that they made of keeping a very, very long drawn out reverb and like a ping pong delay that sounds really, really nice on the vocal. If you want to see an uncut version of this video, check out the link in the description.
Look at all the promises that I've kept.
That was a beautiful rundown. Beautiful. And it's not easy to do when you're going that breathy, because intonation is kind of hard to pinpoint and be very, very specific on. It's possible. I mean, obviously, it is possible. I mean, this has probably been auto-tuned, but still, the concept remains true that it's hard to keep it very, very in tune as you do it so breathy. The other thing is that he's capitalizing on the use of the reverb and the ping pong delay by keep ending each one of the lines super short. So he's not holding out the note, he's chopping it off.
I've wept.
So he keeps it very, very short. Instead of
I've wept,
he could hold it out, but he doesn't hold it out. And the same thing with the rundown, he cuts it right as soon as he hits that bottom note, he cuts it off short. And then that really takes advantage of the space between the lines. If you're interested in getting a free lesson with me, please check out the link right here.
Into your hands, here's my soul to keep.
So I think that, I mean, this isn't the original lyric video, so heart is the incorrect word here. It's actually, I put my all into your hands. So that's just one mistake here that you're going to see on the screen. But again, here he's keeping it super breathy. Nothing is coming, even though he's going into his falsetto, he's not going into any sort of mix. He keeps everything either breathy, chest, or falsetto.
I'll let you in with all that I can.
So that just changed the speed of the song. He just entered into his full mix there with a little bit of cry on I.
You're not hard to reach, and you've blessed me with.
And he does a beautiful thing on reach. He stays into a mix and then lets go into falsetto.
Hard to reach, reach.
So he kind of like turns it on with a strong E. That's strong. And then lets go of it on M part of the word.
Reach. Ever known, you give me purpose.
And he does such a gorgeous job of adding compression to the vocal and then going back to the breathy sound seamlessly in every line. And so he's not staying in one mode. He's keeping it very, very dynamic.
Giving me purpose.
And I love his very subtle vibrato that's almost like a shake in his voice. It just gives it so much more emotion.
Sending out a farewell to my friends.
Going up into his super, super light falsetto, and it's just so wispy and angelic. It's expertly executed.
For my sins, oh, would you please?
And he really, almost every chance he gets, he capitalizes on the very sparse instrumental and the space between the lines by cutting off short and allowing the production to take over to add in that reverb and delay.
All that time we spent, my spirit's at ease.
And even though he's going breathy through all this part, he has varying levels of volume and intensity. So he's getting all these like sub dynamics of like, I'm not in full voice, but I'm not fully in falsetto either. I'm not in a breathy. Like, it's just blurring all the lines between the modes of the voice.
Wherever I am, you're not hard to read.
And so there he's using actually the beginnings of the lines to come in soft, and then he's crescendoing into the ends of the lines and adding a lot of intensity and compression to his vocal cords as he goes into the end of the line. And even though the end of the line is lower down in his range, he still kind of uses that same approach, which is very cool. Most people would kind of do the opposite, digging into their higher range and then loosening up as they go to their lower range.
And you've given me the best gift.
And so there he uses a lot of vocal fry. And so you can hear just a little bit of vocal fry right at the beginning of that. That helps to close up his vocal cords, adds a little bit of a cry to it. And it just sound like that's where it really soars. And you get this kind of very emotive approach to the song. And so that's for those of you who are wanting to know, how do I get emotion into my voice? It's either adding in some compression with a cry underneath it, or adding in some breath, because the breath definitely adds an emotional aspect to it. And there you've got that very subtle harmony on purpose, just adds that extra element that wasn't there in the first chorus. So there he's coming in with a breathy oh.
You are my everything.
And there is a full you are my everything.
Oh, you are my everything.
And all of his runs are very much following the same pattern of ending very abruptly. That's how he keeps the style of this song. And it's a thread that runs through the whole thing, that each one of the runs ends right at the end. And he specifically puts the runs at the end of each line.
To understand that these, like, that's not who you are. You know you're trying to be the best you can be, but that's...
This is a very interesting choice to put this at the end of the song. It's very clearly just like an unscripted talk, that conversation he was having. And it sounds like it was recorded by an iPhone, just like in a very casual environment, because you can hear a lot of background noise. Doesn't sound like professional studio quality. I'm sure they did some editing to it, but overall it just kind of sounds like it's just his natural spoken voice through an iPhone. So it's definitely a very interesting choice, and to be like kind of just him speaking out his opinions, and you know, something that I think very much talks to the title of the song and about his purpose and his struggle with his purpose.
Sometimes I'm weak and I'm gonna do it. And it's like, I'm not giving myself grace, I'm just like...
And it seems like it's bits and pieces from a conversation, so we don't get all the context of what exactly he's talking about, but it definitely sounds like there's a struggle there, and he's struggling within himself of just, you know, how much understanding he should give himself and how much he should push himself. So it's a very interesting choice, and one that I actually really liked, and just kind of put my own talk at the end of my cover of this song. It's a very clear spiritual outpouring for Justin. So I'm really excited to see what Jungkook did with this song.
Feeling like I'm breathing my last breath.
All right, so very much in the same vein of Justin's approach and instrumentation, there's really not much change by Jungkook here. He's really keeping it very true to the original.
Look at all the promises that I kept.
So he's there starting to make a few changes. He's starting to dig in a little bit more into his full voice on certain parts, bringing out a little bit of a mix. But it's very, very delicately done. So it's not like a clear and distinct switch. It's done extremely smoothly.
It's my soul to keep. I'll let you win without...
So here where Justin was going more full voice, Jungkook's keeping it breathy, but adding it a cry from that breathy place. I've really never heard this done before. It would be very interesting to try to mimic this and try to like get this in my own voice. I would love to play around with this approach, because it's not something that I'm very comfortable with and have done often. So it would be really cool to try this out.
You give me purpose.
So even though there's not much change, Jungkook is definitely putting his signature on it. He's making slight pitch variations, like where he's changing the melody just a little bit. And he's definitely making different choices in how he's approaching different parts of the song. So he's not approaching it the exact same way Justin did, which puts his own flair on it, even though it's so close. Like, it's as far as instrumentation, just his vocal, but he's putting his own spin. Sending out a farewell to my friend. All right, so interesting choice there. He definitely held out the O into the next line. So it was a very clear single vocal that was coming on the O, and then it doubled up when the second vocal came in at the tail end of the O. So that for sure was not in one take. Whereas Justin's approach, it could have been one take. I mean, I'm sure it wasn't, because most studio recordings of anything is a Frankenstein of all different takes of a vocal. But it allowed the impression for it to seem like it was one take. Or if he was doing it live, he'd be able to do it in one take. Whereas Jungkook's approach, he wouldn't be able to do that exactly in one take. Ask her to forgive me for my sins. Yeah, so he's making minor variations, like for my, and he kind of like did a slide into that note, not hitting it directly on, which is, again, a style choice, but it kind of gives it that kind of sliding feel to it. And again, here he's holding back from going fully into a compressed and intense sound. We all know that Jungkook can in all of the BTS songs he does, but here he's really holding back, keeping it all really breathy. More than grateful for the time we spent. Okay, so there he started on Grateful and Spent. He started to dig into more compression. You can hear it there. Whereas the rest is still breathy. I put my heart into your hands. Alright, so there on You, he really digs in. He gets a lot more intensity in that. You give me purpose. And so it's important to note also that his vocal has a very different sort of production on it. Doesn't have that ping-pong effect of the vocal bouncing in the left-right speaker. And it also doesn't have as strong of a reverb effect on it. And I think since this is more of the climax of the song, he is digging more into his voice and getting more compression here. You are my everything. So even that part, he keeps very breathy. Like, all this part, he keeps super, super breathy. And I really like the harmony. So he chose to keep the harmony all the way through. So it seems like he chose to use this piano piece at the end as an outro, as opposed to putting on his own kind of monologue that could have been here. I was kind of hoping that Jungkook would do something with this end part, you know, maybe throw on a different vocal, add some more verses, or even just throw on his own monologue, but he chose to just leave it as a piano outro. So I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please hit the like button. The algorithm loves that. And if you want to see more videos, check out that one. You're gonna like it.